guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm actually going to assist Kaylin on her switching out the starter on our Caterpillar 3208. Alright, so real quick, if you're not subscribed already, please smash that subscribe button. We definitely want to be able to bring you guys some more videos and more changes and upgrades to the boat. So the best way to do that is for you to subscribe. So, alright, so let's get into it. So we got the starter now. We put it back into the boat, so now it's resting in there in its location. And Kaylin is trying to, what we're trying to do is get the top bolt seated so that the weight of the starter holds. So that bolt right there on the top with that arrow is where we're trying to get started, trying to thread that. We got three bolts to put in to hold the starter, and then we're going to do all the wire. So this is the first bolt we're trying to get threaded. That way we can get that thing held in place and work on the other. So she's trying to get situated and figure out what's the best way to get that. She realized that sitting on top of the engine wasn't going to work. So she climbed down into the hole, which is amazing because it gives so much better view for her. It's not something I can definitely do, so I'm very thankful to have her to be able to do this. So she's down there and getting that threaded, and I think she actually did all three of them down there, got them all seated. So the engine or the starter right now is holding by itself. So all right, so you can see here there's three bolts that we're trying to do. Those three right there. So we've got them now mounted and threaded. They're all the way through. Took a quick break heading back. She had to stretch her legs after being down there for a little bit. Kind of an awkward position, as you can imagine. So you guys also noticed there was a little bit of rust down there. The rust little part is something I'm trying to prevent. Curious other captains out there, if you maintain a sport fish, what do you do to prevent rust? I know I've got a wire brush and I have some primer paint that I tack on some places, but see if there's anything better out there that maybe you guys recommend. So, all right, so we're getting back into it now. I am removing the terminal or the lug nuts on the end for the positive cable and the negative cable. So we're just kind of pulling both of those off. They gave us new bolts and everything from the factory when they did the replacement, so I had to remove those. Kaylin's tightening the final bolts for mounting it to the engine, and then she's actually also grabbing wires, so putting on that control wire, putting on the positive cable wires, and making sure that we have them all. There's a couple wire harnesses that we had to grab and make sure we had everything on there correct. So I'm just removing those two nuts for the large cables. She's putting those all the reds on, and the yellow and red control wire that comes from that solenoid. And then she's going to come up and work, and she's going to finish up doing the wire. So she's actually coming out right now. So I've got all of the wires attached, and she's going to come out and go ahead and attach or finish up tightening those control wires and the positive and negative. So this kind of happened a little bit by accident. The one night we went to go start the boat and it didn't start. We spent the weekend trying to diagnose it, and we thought it was a bad ground. It turned out that was actually correct. So we found out the ground issue was inside the starter, so we had it rebuilt overnight. And this is us at about 11 o'clock at night replacing it so we can go out on the weekend. So here she is. She's got that small wrench down there. The control wire, it's under the exhaust, so it's kind of at an awkward angle. But there it is right there with that arrow. Tightening that, that's the one that comes from the solenoid that tells the engine when to throw power, when to start. So then she's going in and tightening the positive cable, the negative cable. I'm actually looking at the other engine at this time and verifying that we have all of the wires that we need to have on the starter. Last thing I wanted to do is turn the battery switch back on and have a wire dangling or offset. So here she's just doing the finishing touches, giving it that last boost of energy, getting it all wrapped up. So this is one of the things that's amazing with having a first mate like this. So she's able to get into these spots and really doesn't mind getting her hands dirty. I think she was actually kind of excited to have a little bit of a different role and play the role of the diesel mechanic today. And I really just basically assisted her and pointed her in the right direction, but she pretty much did all this work. So after that, she actually realized that there was another issue down in the generator. So here she is again, jumping down there, trying to get that thing fixed. There's never a dull moment, never a break on a boat when you have this. So here it is. So if you did like this video, please hit the like button, send a comment below, hit that share. We really appreciate it. And we'll talk to you guys later.